made it.
Wow.
You know what this reminds me of?
What?
Nowhere I've ever been.
Got one, two friends, two paddle boards.
Yeah, buddy. All right, fellas, Rob.
Wild Basin in Rocky Mountain National Park.
Somewhere close to Evergreen. We're gonna get some drone shots, some follow me shots. Rob's the guy behind the camera.
What up?
I'm gonna be doing the follow me. And this is my friend Rebecca. Let's go, team!
Rob and Cole here. We've traversed across, what's it called, Cunningham Lake?
Wellington.
Wellington Lake, same thing. We've traversed across the lake known as Wellington. And we've got threatening skies in the horizon. So, as a result, we're gonna traverse across this 2 mile radius lake.
We're the only people on it right now.
Yeah, that's probably not a great sign that we're the only persons on Mother Nature's water. But here's to making it back. Strikes us. Over and out. As we continue to traverse, we've seen some close lightning strikes. Too close for comfort.
We just barely managed to get out of the way of the lightning.
My very rudimentary system of detecting how far away the lightning is projects to be about 5 miles. And fortunately, only 100 feet or so, stone's throw, some would say, depending on how good of a stone thrower you are, away from land. Our friend Rebecca has comfortably made it back in record time. She's trying to take state. She's working toward the 2024 Olympics and a scholarship, that too. Trying to get that ever elusive scholarship. But you know what they say. Most of us go D1 in something other than sports.
Signing off.
Is it Colorado or Colorado? I always wonder.
Colorado.
Colorado.
I don't know what this Midwestern accent is, but.
Is it Colorado? Is it? Like, I've heard right.
Rob, take us on a tour here.
Well, welcome to my crib. So we got the 30-foot ceilings. We got a sliding door that takes you to nature.
And, wow.
Don't
nature
expect,
is right out there.
Yeah, I mean, first that's a doozy. Come into my kitchen, we have this beautiful gas stove. I mean, look at this range. Ooh. Samsung, it matches. Even matches the fridge, so that's good for OCD people. This tile is a family heirloom.
Predates back.
Yeah, this is what the settlers had when the first settler, Lewis and Clark, came here.
Yeah.
They built this.
It's common knowledge.
A family heirloom passed down from Lewis and Clark themselves. Come over here, so. This snowy Chloe.
Yeah.
Snowy Chlo, if you will.
Who's this? Whose daughter is this?
Someone.
I don't even know anymore. But this was built that tree yonder way. If you step into my back here, a beautiful perch for sipping coffee. Sipping on some casuals, if you will. I'm just not used to this elevation thing.
Oh, look, a guy.
Oh.
Look at him.
And here we have the wild American deer grazing.
He's getting his munch on.
And that's nature with David Attenborough. But for real, I mean, this weather, I didn't think I needed to bring jeans, but it's 66 right now.
And we can't.
It's warmer in downtown Denver.
We can't forget the rest of the house. We got the bathroom. There we go. Bathroom and bedroom. With a good view. Here she goes. Say goodbye, everybody.
Ready?
Yeah.
How much air did I get?
Oh. Pretty good.
1 foot.
Yeah.
That's 6 inches.
Okay. So, Rob, what's your Yelp rating over for this hike?
Man, I mean, where do I begin? Got to see 3 waterfalls, hella nice views.
Got to stand under a waterfall.
Got to stand under the aforementioned waterfall. I give it 2 thumbs up.
Wow.
I'm
how does that equate to Yelp review?
Well, I'm creating a new
how
Yelp.
How much is 1 thumb?
The beauty is in the eye of the beholder.
And this has been a Yelp review by our team.